Class 10, today we are going to revise the chapter Triumph of Surgery. Triumph means victory. Surgery, what is surgery? A surgery is a place where the animals, they are kept and they are taken care of. You can say it's a sort of hospital for the animals, right? Okay, why it is called as Triumph of Surgery? Because the dog whose name was Tricky, he was suffering from a problem of excessive feeding. He was suffering from a problem of excessive feeding. And it is because of this reason that the dog has stopped any interest in eating. He was not at all interested in any kind of eating. So there are three main characters. And who is Mrs. Pumphrey? Mrs. Pumphrey, she is the owner of the dog. Owner of the dog and Mr. James Harriet. Who is Mr. James Harriet? He is the veterinary doctor. So he was responsible of taking care of Tricky, and ultimately what happened that the dog, when Mrs. Pumphrey, first of all, he has made a call to James Harriet, okay? So James Harriet had a first look of Tricky. So what kind of dog it was? It was a dog having plump figure with his both the legs moved to the sides, having a robust figure, and the dog's tongue was, you can say, lolling up out of his mouth, and saliva, it was, you can say, drooping down, and ultimately the dog was given, you can say, unappealing look. It was completely fat. So Mr. James Harriet, who was an expert doctor, he knew that what problem this dog is suffering from. So Mrs. Pumphrey, she is telling Mr. James Harriet that the dog is not eating anything, okay? So James Harriet, he has asked Mrs. Pumphrey, that he said that he has told her not to give any special food to the dog. But Mrs. Pumphrey said that she is giving some extra food. What she was giving to the dog? What she was giving Horlicks at night to induce more sleep. Okay, she's also giving the dog his favorite chocolates as well as cakes, some cod liver oil, and a bowl of Horlicks at night. Okay, so in order to build strength, okay, so Mr. James Harriet, who knew that the dog is not actually suffering from the problem of malnutrition, but actually he is suffering from the problem of excessive nutrition. Okay. So then up to the next question, James Harriet asked whether you have taken your dog for some exercise or for some outdoor walk. And to this, what was the answer of Mrs. Pumphrey? She said that these days, the gardener Hodgkin, okay, what was the name of the gardener? Hodgkin, okay, he was suffering from the problem of lumbago. What is problem of lumbago? He is suffering from the problem of lumbago. What does it mean? Lumbago means some problem due to muscle pain in the leg. Okay, so this is the reason why leg pain. So he said that he is not able to move, and it is because of this reason that he was not able to take the dog out for a walk. So he said this is the reason why the dog is not undergoing any kind of exercise. Okay, but James Harriet, what was the first suggestion to Mrs. Pumphrey? James Harriet, what was his first suggestion? Mr. James Harriet, he has given the first suggestion to Mrs. Pumphrey was that to give some exercise to the dog. If she will be giving some exercise to the dog will definitely improve. But what happened? After some days again, Mrs. Pumphrey, she has again made a call to Mr. James Harriet. So this time, what happened? She was crying. She was completely in tears. Why she was completely in tears? Because she was complaining that the dog is not eating anything. He is also denying of eating his favorite food, his favorite dishes also. He is not at all eating. He is not at all ready to eat even a chunk of food. And moreover, he is also denying to eat his favorite dish. And he has also bouts of vomiting. What he has? Bouts of vomiting. Okay. So to this, Mr. James Harriet, who was an expert and experienced doctor. Expert as well as experienced doctor. So what he has said? He has said that his dog, he needed to be hospitalized. So what kind of special attention, what kind of special care was provided to Ricky? So when he has seen the dog coming, he was, you can say, wrapped up in his tweed coat. It means he has different kind of coats. Okay, different kind of coats to be worn in different kind of weathers. For summer, he has raincoats. For summer season, he has different kind of coats. And for winter season, he has he has tweed coats, okay, and furry coats. Right? So Mr. James Harrier, he has very well known to this fact that actually the problem of the dog is not that he is suffering from malnutrition, but the dog needed some extra company, he needed some exercise, and he needed some, you can say, special care. So he announced to Mrs. Pumphrey that the dog needs to be hospitalized. And to this, Mrs. Pumphrey, who was a rich lady, okay, who did not have any child, and she's showering all her love, okay, she's bestowing all her love upon that dog. So this Mrs. Pumphrey, she is a she's just an explanation, or she is just a symbol of the real symbols. She's symbolic of the life of rich people, that how possessive they are for their dogs and as well as pets also. So she was not ready, but then what happened? Mr. James Harriet, he has announced that tomorrow he will come and will take the dog to his surgery. So finally, when he has gone, there were number of servants who were attending the dog. Okay, they all have come with the special cushions. Okay, favorite toys of Tricky. They were running after him, and they have brought his lunch ball, his breakfast ball, his dinner ball, his supper ball, different kind of balls. But actually, do you know that the dog actually needs this kind of attention? No, the dog does not need this kind of attention. Okay, but what it actually needs is only the normal environment, okay, which is required. So what happened? So all the, you can say, Mrs. Pumphrey, along with Mrs. Pumphrey, all the maids at the home, they were also in tears when he has pushed the Tricky to the back seat of his car, and number of servants, they were coming running with all the different kind of equipments that were related to Tricky, and he has rushed off his car down to the corner of the city. So finally, when Tricky was brought at surgery, what kind of behavior he was showing? First of all, he was not at all acquainted with the other, you can say, with the other dogs who were present there. He was just moving and was sitting on one side, okay? So first day, he was not given anything, okay? For 2 to 3 days, the doctor was only giving him, providing him only what kind of food? Only liquid diet, okay? Some liquid he is going to provide to the dog. And after 2 days, he has seen that when the person who was responsible for putting all the, you can say, balls for the dogs filled with food, whose name was Tristan, okay? So he was putting all the, you can say, balls of the food for the dogs. Then ultimately, all the dogs, there was the sound of licking of the food. And ultimately, what happened, Tricky came and he has come to one of the shining balls, okay? So it means that at this time, Tricky has developed some sense of likeness for the food. Then what happened? So at this moment, next day, what happened? That an extra ball was placed for Tricky, and he has finished almost his food. So this, at this moment, what happened? Mr. Harriet came to know that now the dog is making progress. So he is often, you can say, dodging the questions of Mrs. Pumphrey. She is often asking whether the dog has been provided with the right type of coat according to the weather, whether the food is being given to according to the ball which is fixed for supper, dinner, as well as breakfast. She's also inquiring that whether the dog is being given his favorite cushions or his favorite, you can say, toys. So these things are not at all of any importance for Mr. James Harriet, right? So what happened? He said that now Tricky is making progress. So listening to this again, Mrs. Pumphrey, who was overprotective in nature towards the dog, She has sent dozens of eggs, like for a dozen at one time. Is this required for the dog? No. So that was just a treat for the people at the surgery. They were having 2 eggs Daily boiled eggs in the breakfast. They were not giving it to Tricky. And moreover, he said the treat was actually at that time when wine was also sent for the dog. Wine. Okay, in order to improve his digestion. Yes. Okay. And ultimately, they had actually wines that they people used to have. They does not contain, you can say it has different alcohol. It has different concentrations of alcohol. Not so much concentrated. They were just used as the for digestion purposes. Okay. So for this reason, they have sent the wine. And he said, actually, it was, of course, a treat to keep this type of dog at surgery. And finally, when this dog was kept at surgery, it was really a treat for all of them. He said, during the lunch hours and at the dinners, we, all the staff at the surgery, they had a glass of wine after that. Then Mrs. Pumphrey, he said, but I was not so selfish. Mr. James Harrier said that he was not so selfish. Finally, what he has to do, he has to disclose the actual situation of Tricky, that his dog is finally well and she can come at any time. So the moment she heard, the next moment, after within 15 minutes, she was outside. The James Harriet has seen that outside her glass window, glass door, a black colored, you can say, car stopped, and Mrs. Pumphrey, along with number of, you can say, maids, she has come, and she was finally in tears when she has held the dog into her lap, and the dog also jumped, who also wanted her, you can say, mistress back, and finally the dog was with her. Okay, so this is all about this short chapter. But this, through this short chapter, the writer is explaining about the actual situation also, right? Actual situation, that what kind of life these rich people, they used to live. Okay, what kind of special attention, what kind of special care is being provided by them, because they are providing special attention and special care. This is sometimes, you can say, harmful on the part of the animal. Sometimes that the animal, he doesn't like to live in that kind of environment. Okay, so this is how you can say the situation of Tricky was improved. Okay, now let me give you some questions. Okay, MCQ type questions from this chapter. So first is, first question is, what does the reference to Tricky as a silky little object signify? Silky little object was used in the chapter. What does it signify? Options I'm giving. Tricky was a very small, rather pampered dog. Or Tricky was comfortably attired in fine silks in warm coats. Unlike the other dogs, Tricky had lived in the lap of luxury with care and grooming. Or the narrator's mockery of Tricky's life and treatment with Mrs. Pumphrey. Which last one? Huh? B or B? B for ball. It means that Tricky was comfortably attired in fine silk and warm coats. You are saying. You mean that silky little object means that. But actually, it is, unlike other dogs, he was given a special attention and care, and he was living with care and special grooming. Yeah, this is the answer. Okay? Huh? C option. Okay? It mean, doesn't mean that he was clad in silken clothes. Nowhere in the chapter we have read that. What we have read, that he was taken, he was brought up under special care and attention. So this we have read. Next is, why does the narrator describe being tramped on and squashed as joyous? What does it mean? To suggest the irony about the strange ways of dogs? Why does narrator describe being tramped on and squashed? Tramped on and squashed. He wanted to explain the irony about the strange way of dogs, or to mention the simple pleasures of canine life. Canine life means dog's life, because they have special type of teeth called canines. So to compare it to Tricky's either playtime at the house, or to direct attention towards Tricky's successful recovery. It is one option. It was tramped and squashed, means as joys. His joys were no longer his joys. What are the joys for Tricky? What are the joys for Tricky? He's living in his own way. He wanted to live in his own way. He wanted to live his life in according to his own one. He never wanted such type of extra attention. This was making the dog, you can say, sulky, lazy also. Okay? So it means that it was an irony on the actual situation of the dog. Right? That how dog it suffered. Okay? Next, Tricky's characteristics. Which are the Tricky's characteristics? Okay, tell me. Selfish, yes or no? Okay. Happy, greedy. Greedy, he was confident. Yes. And sturdy and cruel. Let me tell why you will pick these options, because in the chapter it was mentioned he was fighting like a tiger for his share at meal times and hunting rats in the old hen house at night. These were the activities that Tricky was undergoing when he was at surgery. So from this we have come to know he was happy, he was confident, and as well as he was sturdy, strong he has turned out to be. He has turned out to be a muscular dog at that time. Because earlier, what kind of dog he was? He was just, you can say, with his tongue lolling out of the jaws. And moreover, his both the legs were situated on the sides of the body. Okay, they were wide apart. Next, what were Tricky's joys, present joys? Barking at strangers, taking away food of other dogs, fighting and struggling with other dogs, and none of the above. I'm talking about when he is at surgery. Fighting and struggling with other dogs. Okay, because now he is fighting and he is struggling. So this is the reason he was enjoying there. So what discernible change was there in him? Discernible change means which is visible. Okay. So sometimes you feel difficulty in understanding the question also. What it was, eating little, sleeping soundly, taking leisurely walk, or having the best of time? Having the best of time, she's right. It was eating little. At surgery, he was eating little. Later on, he has developed love for food. Okay. Then sleeping soundly, no, he was enjoying. Okay, then taking leisurely walk, he was not at all taken for walks and all. Okay, and last one is having the best of time. He was enjoying his best time at surgery. So this is the right answer here. Next, Tricky had no dash of any kind. Regular food, regular exercise, medical treatment or problem. What B? He was medical treatment. She's right. I said Tricky had no dash of any kind. He was not given any medical treatment. Food he was given. Exercise he was doing while playing with other dogs. So medical treatment is the right answer. Okay, next. Next is, Tricky discovered the joys of being. What he enjoyed? Balled over, jumped on, squashed every few minutes, all the three above. Okay, right, fine, good. Which word does shaggy not correspond to? Shaggy. What is the meaning of shaggy? It's dirty, filthy. Okay, shaggy. And now, I am giving you the options and you will tell which of the options does not correspond to being shaggy. First is lazy, bushy, untidy and thin. Hairy, bushy, untidy and thin. Not correspond. Not wala aapne choose karna hai, which is not corresponding to it. Untidy means shaggy. Not, yes, thin. Thin is the right answer. Thin hi aayega. Okay, right. It is thin. Which does not mean shaggy. Not mean. Okay, when the examiner want to confuse you, he will always put not. What does it not correspond to? Okay, next. Mrs. Pumphrey is in tears. Why? She is sad and depressed. She has been hurt by her pet. Mr. Harriet has offended her. She is excited at the recovery of her pet. First of all, think carefully. Why Mrs. Pumphrey is in tears? She is sad and depressed. She has been hurt by her pet. Mr. Harriet has offended her. She is excited at the... What's the option? What's the option? Oh my God. I explained when I just discussed summary that she was in tears when she has seen her dog. Why? Because she was so happy to see her dog back. And me, have I given that option? Have I given that she was going to surgery? Why Mrs. Harriet, Mrs. Pumphrey was in tears? Options were, she was sad and depressed. She has been hurt by her pet. Harriet has offended her. And last one is, she is excited at the recovery. This is our right option. It is because he was going to that surgery. Now next, see next one. See the next one. Okay, now see the next one. The triumph of surgery, exclaims Mrs. Pumphrey. What does she convey about her state of mind? When Mrs. Pumphrey said, it is the triumph of surgery, what she wanted to convey through this? What was her state of mind? See, she was grateful, regretful, excited, or wishful. What is the meaning of regret? Then I say regret. Wishful? Suppose, now 1 minute, listen to me. You have a dog. He was admitted to hospital. When you say to the doctor that it's just because of you, what you want to speak about? What you want to say? Oh my God. I was not knowing that you people don't know even ABC of this chapter. She was grateful. She was thankful. It is just because of you this has happened. She was grateful. What is the meaning of being wishful? First of all, tell me, what is the meaning of being wishful? To have some wish. She was not wishful. Vineet, I'm talking when the dog has been recovered. She said this word. I said it was the triumph of surgery. And she spoke these words only at the end. Too much confusion you people have. Next. Mr. Harriet is a homeopathic doctor, veterinary doctor. Thank God, you know. Finally. One answer was right. Actually, I was expecting you people will say, ma'am, he was a homeo doctor. Huh? Which one? It is not maternity, it is veterinary. Next one, give the answer to this. You people enjoy MCQs, but you don't know the answers because you don't know the depths of the chapter. Yes, concept clear and say. Next one. Okay, now listen. Tears of dash shown in Mrs. Pomfrey's eyes. When Mrs. Pomfrey was crying at the last, what kind of tears was that? Just see. She was, it was joy. Joy and gratitude, sadness or repentance? Joy and gratitude. Now you got because she was thankful to the doctor. Joy and gratitude. Okay. What does triumph not correspond to? Means I'm speaking four options. And what does triumph does not mean? Triumph doesn't mean. See, it is victory. Second is defeat, conquest, and win. Let me write. What does triumph not correspond? Not correspond. Victory, defeat, win. Or one more option, conquest. What is the meaning of conquest? What is meaning of conquest? Then why are you aiming like a layman? Aise thodi na kisi bhi option ko correct kar do. Keshav, this was so easy. So last question. His eyes, bloodshot and rheumy, stared ahead and his tongue lolled from his jaws. What does it indicate? His eyes, bloodshot and rheumy, stared straight and his tongue lolled from his jaws. He was ill. Suffering from ill health due to overeating, happiness at gorging, discomfort but happiness or relaxed attitude. Overeating. He's not having good health because of overeating. Okay. He was overeaten. He was overfed by Mrs. Pomfrey. So student, that's all for today, and tomorrow we will continue with the next chapter.